Snipes opening up, as he said he would, circling around, trying to get away from Cotier. Cotier doing exactly what he said he was going to do. Try to cut him off. Drop the right hand in. There it goes. It's a very small ring, and these are huge men.
It is the minimum of 18 feet, which, as we mentioned earlier, should be all in favor of Henry Cotier.
And it has a very spongy surface. Instead of felt, it has foam rubber under it, and the fighters are sinking into it, which is very good for Cotier.
What happened to Cotier to the body?
Cotier looking to do his homework early. That powerful right hand of Cotier to the body.
And Cotier has made a strong recovery since sustaining a serious fracture of that right hand earlier in his career, an injury he re-aggravated, but a successful operation repaired the shattered hand.
Gave rise to the term the bionic fist. And he certainly has a powerful right hand.
Cotier loves to talk to his opponents in the ring, and he's been doing that here in the first round.
In this case, I think it doesn't make much difference because nobody can understand him.
Oh, right hand by Snipes. I should say by Cotier. And both Cotier and Snipes ended up lunging into the ropes.
This small ring is going to be a factor in this fight. It's all to Cotier's favor. Snipes can't keep up this running around for 10 rounds. Cotier's conserving his energy. He's not bounced once.
No. Body blow by Cotier, and that stung Snipes, who's had a difficult time here on the first round.
First round, it looks like a very nervous fighter against a very confident and secure fighter. Snipes doing something that's an absolute sin in boxing. That's closing his eyes when he gets punched at.
Cotier continues to stalk Snipes.
Snipes has to throw that right hand, and he's going to keep him off. Snipes is throwing a very feeble left jab that's not doing anything at all to Cotier. Cotier's just measuring.
And Snipes is put down! Eddie Cotier putting Romano Snipes down! Snipes told his partner he's all right. You saw the right hand of Cotier. Final seconds, round number one, and Snipes just looking to hang on. Ronaldo Snipes was put down in round number one and able to hang on. First time in his professional career that Snipes has been down.
And now Snipes knows he's got to fight Cotier. He cannot just jive around with him. He's got to come in with everything he's got. That was a winging right hand that Snipes just threw. He's got to throw something hard at Cotier.
His long suit is the jab. But as you mentioned earlier, Ferdy, it's been all Cotier, who has been able to stalk and very calmly utilize his fight plan.
Looks like they butted head. Looks like there's a little blood above the right eyebrow of Snipes. Reynaldo Snipes with a little blood showing above the right eyebrow.
Right hand by Snipes did not have any damaging effect on Cotier. We are 1 minute in, round two. Henry Cotier, South Africa, has already put Ronaldo Snipes down in the first round.
At this stage, the class of each fighter is showing. Cotier has been in championship competition twice. Snipes, this is his biggest fight. He's tentative, he's scared.
And Cotier hitting and holding on the break. And warned by the referee, Joe Cortez.
And that's called protect yourself at all times. That's what I'm talking about in the difference in class. Snipes should know better. He should not look to the referee for protection.
This is the start of a big day of sports here on NBC. Baseball makes its return with the All-Star game tonight, starting at 8 o'clock. And we'll be going to Cleveland during the course of NBC Sports World for All-Star updates with Brian Gumbo. He'll be chatting with National League All-Star third baseman Mike Schmidt, Kansas City manager, and the manager of the American League All-Stars, Jim Fry. Left hand by Snipes.
Snipes has got to put something in there and get brave. He's overreacting, too scared to these punches.
And Cotier and Snipes. Snipes tie each other up as the referee Cortez breaks the fighters again. What is hit by Cochia, and Snipes nearly went down for the second time.
Cochia's just measuring him. He's just waiting to drop that right hand in. Unless Snipes can put some hurt on Cochia, he's in for a long or maybe a short afternoon.
And we are now final seconds. Round two. Scheduled for 10. Another vicious left hand by Cochia.
Knockdown by Hedy Cochia.
Powerful hook. There it is. That's a left hook that got him down. It's a legitimate lockdown. I don't think he'll recover from that right now.
And we are on to round three. Undefeated Ronaldo Snipes at 21-0. Looking scared right from the start.
Too tentative. He's overreacting to punches. He's drawing back, which makes Cochia able to go forward with another punch and catch him.
That time Cochia not able to land off the spin move by Snipes. Right hand by Snipes. And the crowd responding, but Cochia comes right back.
Cochia had absolutely no regard for Mr. Snipes. He just took a right hand flush on the chin.
Again, Snipes tries the roundhouse right, and it does not connect.
Well, that's the outer edges of desperation when you hit a guy with your best right hand shot and it doesn't even move.
Left hand by Cochia was able to land. Now Snipes had Cochia for an instant in the corner. Looks like he cut Cochia. Slight cut.
Snipes is beginning to recover from that first round knockdown. He's beginning to fight a little bit harder now. And that's what he's got to do, go toe-to-toe and gamble.
What time by Snipes again of the roundhouse variety. Halfway point, round three. Cochia looking to measure Snipes with the left hand.
And the only thing that Snipes has going for him right now is youth and the hope that Cochia will wear out as he's done in other fights. Because make no mistake, he's blown the first two rounds big.
Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Bernie Petrenko, were at the new Westchester Theater, Tarrytown, New York. Scheduled for 10, and Hedy Cochia again loading up. And that time, with the right with the left hand.
Picture-perfect combination. Shot to the body, shot to the head, and now he's out there plugging away.
Snipes walked into that one after this another round. Round four, and it's been all Hedy Cochia, the 26-year-old out of South Africa, looking to put himself right back in the title picture. Back in June of 1979, came up with that shocking first-round knockout of the one-time heavyweight champion, Leon Spinks. Then October of 79, Fort John Tate lost by decision in South Africa. Hedy Cochia's wife, his mother, and his child have made the trip and have spent the time here in the United States with Hedy.
Must be happy today.
Cochia also fought Mike Weaver for the title and was knocked out in the 13th round, put out for only the first time in his professional career. Has not fought much recently. Last bout in March, unanimous decision over George Chaplin. This has turned into a brawl here in round four.
The question here is going to be of stamina. If Snipes can survive past round five, that's a question that we've got to answer. Right now he's fighting scared again. There he goes.
Garcia! And that hurts Snipes! And down he goes for the second time! Eddie Garcia again unleashing the right hand!
He's in bad shape, Marv. This time he's got too many minutes to go. Too much time.
We're approaching halfway mark. Round four, Renato Snipes put down for the second time by Eddie Garcia.
Garcia just put the laces right in his face. That wasn't nice.
Body shot delivered by Snipes after he slipped the punch thrown by Garcia.
Snipes fighting back, just got enough left, and that's bad news because if he stands back there and doesn't grab him for the rest of the round, he will suffer a knockdown. No question, Garcia's just measuring, just waiting for the bionic fist to make a connection with a non-bionic jaw. Snipes should be grabbing and holding right now, waiting for his head to clear. He's in awfully bad shape, Mark. He has no reflexes left. He is weak.
And a cut under the right eye of Renato Snipes.
Garcia very patiently waiting for him.
And that's the way he opened up in the first round.
He's waiting for that right hand.
Again, Snipes attempts the roundhouse. That'll be ruled a slip.
That is a definite slip. That was not a punch. It serves to kill time. There's 10 seconds.
All right, leg out. Come on, leg out. So Snipes will last out the round again. Now this is round five. Eddie Garcia has put down Renato Snipes on two occasions in the fourth round and in the first round. Let's take a listen to what took place in the corner of Renato Snipes a moment ago as we watch the action.
You listen to me? Listen to me. You can box, Snipes. You can dance. You're too good for
it. How you feeling here, Snipes?
All right, man. I've been asking three times, man.
Thank you, man.
You're too good a boxer to stand there and slug with the palm. Move, stick, set it up. Don't get in a hurry. It'll come. Bring your hand straight back in your jacket.
Sounds like desperate words in the corner of Renato Snipes.
That's the only thing you can do in the corner is give him hope and send him back out. Right now, Snipes is letting go of that big roundhouse punch. And every time he does that, Garcia measures him with a little tight shot on the inside that really kills Snipes. He should forget that long overhand right. Wait till his head clears up. He's still fighting in the fog. If there was ever a rap on Garcia, it's what's happening right now. He's got a fighter just on the verge of a knockout. He doesn't have the killer instinct to go get him. He's waiting to counterpunch. He should be out there leading.
And the lunging left by Snipes after Garcia was able to slip.
You got to give Ronaldo Snipes credit. He's got the guts. He's coming on. He's the one that was hurt. He's coming on being the aggressor.
And that a question mark concerning Snipes' career because he has yet to be tested. That is until today.
Well, it's a big crossroads for Mr. Snipes. He's been through two before, but this one's really a big hill to climb now.
Again, the measuring by Garcia. And Snipes continues to slip. Than a minute remaining in round five.
Snipes takes his eyes off Garcia when he ducks down. That's a terrible thing to do. You got to watch it. Oh, great shot
by Snipes.
Great hook by Snipes.
He tried to load up on the right but could not connect. He was encouraged by that left hand. And we have tremendous action here in round five.
Snipes chasing Garcia as if the roles were reversed. That's incredible.
Oh, by far Snipes' best.
In a replay, that terrific connecting shot, whang, right to the back of the head. But you see, they tie each other up. There's no action following one punch. Now let's go back to Coetzee's corner, or Snipes' corner, rather. Here's Coetzee's corner. You can't understand anything because they're speaking in Dutch. It sounds like Hitler addressing the Reichstag.
Now this is round six. Ronaldo Snipes with a rally in the fifth round. He's been put down twice by Hedy Coetzee.
And this is a Snipes crowd. They come up to their feet every time the bell rings. They're expecting big things from Mr. Snipes.
Now Snipes, who came out very awkward and very competitive, showing signs of confidence in the last couple of rounds.
Because Coetzee has decided to stand.
The hooks, he was able to land on that first one.
That's the way he's got to fight. He's got to take a chance, let it all fly. He may get hit, but he's got to take a chance on it.
And now it's Coetzee tying up Snipes.
Again, let me remind you that Coetzee wears out in the later rounds. Mr. Snipes is young and strong.
Coetzee looking to measure Snipes as he cornered him. And you have to wonder if Coetzee is not able to land the knockout punch about the ring rust. He has not fought that frequently.
That's certainly a factor right now. Snipes, for the first time, won a round in five tries. First four went to Coetzee. So he still has a chance.
Now that's according to our NBC scorecard. New York with some 35 miles out of New York City, and the crowd all Ronaldo Snipes, who is now fighting out of Yonkers, New York.
The difference in this fight seems to be that Coetzee can put out Snipes with one shot, whereas Snipes is not going to put out Coetzee with one shot. So you're sitting here looking at a guy facing a loaded gun.
Now Snipes going to the jab. That's his most effective weapon.
He's in a corner. He's got to get out.
Less than a minute remaining in round six.
He's able to walk Coetzee out of the corner, which he shouldn't be able to.
Snipes walked into a left hand that time.
Coetzee seems in slow motion compared to Snipes now, who's really picking up steam. With every round, he seems to be getting braver. What an amazing comeback for a guy that's been twice in two legitimate knockdowns.
It was put down on the first, and then put down on the fourth by Hedy Coetzee. And we're final seconds of round six. Hedy Coetzee.
Down now.
Left to the body now.
And this is round seven. Ronaldo Snipes, who has been put down twice by Hedy Coetzee, coming on strong in rounds five and six.
Remember that this is on a round basis. Supplemental points are from the round. Question that Snipes has a chance. By points, he's way behind. So if we go by rounds, as it is in New York, he still has a good chance, and he's getting stronger.
The referee and the two judges score, and the scoring is on that round basis. Judges Carl Castellano, Nick Gamboli.
And remember that while it doesn't make much difference, Snipes is before a wild hometown audience here. This is the area where he made his reputation. These are his fans. Not much action this round, Mark.
It's the first low-key sequence that we've had.
Referee doing a good job. He's got got two very big men to handle, and he's a small man himself.
That is Joe Cortez breaking the fighters of this.
Now they're both showing signs of weariness.
Again, Garcia trying to measure Stipes.
That was nine jabs to the body by Stipes, unanswered by Garcia. Garcia having trouble finding that bouncing ball. The head of Stipes is hard to find all of a sudden.
But Ronaldo successfully slipping punches, slipping that right hand.
I think Snipes is way too tight at the beginning of this fight. He wasn't loose. He's now loose. He's fighting. He finds out that if he moves, he can fight and not get hit. Now he's loose. Now he's almost relaxed. Whereas before, he was tight as a drum.
Start of a big day of sports here on NBC. Baseball making its way back, and right off the bat, one of the season's highlights, the 52nd annual All-Star Game. Of course, the game's greatest names, Pete Rose and Rob Carew, Fernando Valenzuela will start for the National League. Reggie Jackson will be there. Mike Schmidt, Dave Winfield. That's all tonight. Starting at 8 o'clock on NBC. We are final seconds, round 7, scheduled for 10. And we'll be back in a moment. And back in Tarrytown, New York, Marv Albert and the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco. Round 8, and as we watch the action, let's listen to the corner of Ronaldo Stipes.
Stipes, now don't keep your head down. Are you listening to me? Don't keep your head down. No, he comes back with the uppercut. Stick and move. Stick and move. Okay? And you hit with the right.
That's Ronaldo Stipes' stepfather, the Reverend Jimmy Williams, saying don't keep your head down. Uppercut by Garcia got in.
Garcia danced off his feet throwing a jab like the old Floyd Patterson flying through the air jab, and then threw an uppercut. What a strange combination. Had he been caught in the middle of that, he'd have landed in South Africa someplace.
How have you scored to this point?
Well, I've got Snipes coming on, but Garcia's still ahead. Garcia seemed to have paralyzed himself into slow motion in rounds 5, 6, and 7. Now it seems like he was saving himself for the end. He's starting to fight more this round.
Pentagon Bomb, round 8, scheduled for 10. Snipes trying to load up.
Snipes showing signs of weariness. All that bouncing around he's done in the last few rounds may be paying off. Proving an elusive target when he bends over. It's sort of that crab-like stance that Kenny Norton had when he bent way over and you couldn't hit him with the right hand.
Ronaldo Stipes fighting out of Yonkers, New York, grew up in Waukegan, Illinois. And in the hand, with the combination, Garcia was hurt for the first time. Garcia tried to counter with the uppercut.
Garcia stung by a brilliant combination by Stipes.
Right hand by Stipes, but he walked into the right hand of Garcia.
That's the danger here. That one punch that Garcia can put out when Stipes misses.
Less than a minute remaining in the safe round.
Garcia used his gloves to advantage in the corner. He laced them and he put his thumb in. That's the advantage of that thumbless glove we saw used earlier today.
Oh, right hand. That time by Garcia was able to get in on Stipes.
Not hard, but a thing of beauty. A little right uppercut. Mysteriously, Garcia doesn't seem to have much on his punches.
Looked to tire himself out. Unleashing earlier on Stipes. He put Stipes down in the first round and then in round 4. For a rest period by Hedy Garcia. And that'll do it for the safe round. Tip 3-1 for Garcia.
For Garcia. Garcia looked a little bit better that round. I thought it was an even round. He had been asleep 5, 6, and 7.
right hand followed by the left by Snipes, who has come back a long way. Looked to be an early exit for Ronaldo Snipes, the way this one got under him.
Well, Ronaldo has shown all the guts that we thought he had, and he's certainly shown a come back into it spirit. His recuperative powers are amazing.
Snipes at 21-0 with 11 knockouts. That record, according to Ring Magazine. Garcia 24-2 with 13 knockouts.
Oh!
It's the kind of punch that can carry around for you. What a winger.
And Snipes got hit on the way with the right hand by Garcia, who goes right back to Snipes.
That's the danger of those winging punches. When you miss, you can get hit. I think Ronaldo got hit and felt it to his toes. Ronaldo should tie him up now. He got hurt by that counterpunch of Garcia's. Rapidly a fight can change.
Now the crowd chanting for Ronaldo Snipes. We are halfway through the ninth round. Snuffle for Kell. Up tap by Snipes. Not much effect on that one. Up tap by Garcia.
They're mauling inside. And they're doing everything. There's laces. There's elbows. There's forearms. They're just playing football inside here.
Snipes trying to regroup. He was shaken up by that last counter by Garcia.
I think Garcia was shaken by that tremendous overhand right, but he came back. When Snipes missed his overhand right, he got hit. And he's been trying to work his way out of it ever since.
Under a minute left. Ninth round. Snipes put down in round 24, able to come back strong. Snipes, but that time Garcia was able to work it out. And both Garcia and Snipes now suffering from fatigue.
Very sloppy right then. But that's what Snipes needs to survive this round.
Snipes' left eye appears to be on the verge of closing.
He should forget those wrong punches.
And as you see, we are now final seconds, round 9. About, and then unleashed the left hand in the previous round, round number 9. A look at Mark Mercuro, boxing writer for the Gannett newspaper chain and president of the International Boxing Writers Association.
Over 150 writers in this new organization. It may be a new force in boxing. Last round.
All right, 10th and final round.
And this is truly up in the air, Mark. This is truly one of those fights where this round can decide it.
Particularly about Snipes, who has rallied, is fighting virtually in his hometown.
If he can suck it up now, if he can have a great last round, he's got a great chance.
It's Garcia stalking Snipes. And let's see, that was a slip. Garcia was shut down by Snipes.
Oddity, he threw a left hook as he got up and he hit Snipes. He was waiting for him to get up. Again and again, you see, protect yourself at all times. Come to the fore in boxing.
Good body blow by Garcia. On the left hand, answered by Snipes.
Points, he saves it with those big punches. He's getting brave.
Another left hand by Snipes.
That's what he needs. Terry's still waiting. Garcia's still waiting to land that one leveler.
Minute gone by. Tough. And final round has been bombs away from the start. Eddie Garcia putting Snipes down on two occasions. First round, and then again on the fourth. But Snipes coming on very strong, and I'm sure winning much respect around the country.
And now Snipes showing extreme fatigue. As Garcia leans all over and tries to take advantage.
Snipes continues to try and connect with the roundhouse window right hand.
That's won him a lot of points. I guess he wants to stick with it, but he gets killed every time he misses it.
Right hand by Stripes, followed by the left as Garcia counters to the head. And we approach 1 minute left in this tenth.
Both fighters trading punches evenly. When just when you think one guy has the advantage, the other guy comes in. It is very windy in a heavyweight fight.
Seconds left. Tenth and final. Ronaldo Snipes with the unbeaten record on the line at 21-0. Eddie Garcia looking to make it back from inactivity. A man who has fought on two occasions for the heavyweight championship came out very strong, but Snipes carrying the fight in the final round.
Snipes just made one heck of a fight of this, but I think the edge is because he's dropped him twice, and he's finishing much, much stronger.
Final second, 10th, and final round, and this one will go the distance. That is it. So we will go to a decision.
Officials. Carol Castellano scores it 3 rounds Snipes, 6 rounds Coetzee, 1 round even. Judge Nick Gamboli scores it 5 rounds Snipes.
Things are flying.
He has upset Eddie Garcia in a controversial decision. Let's go to the ring. Here's Corbin.
Well, as you can see, the debris is flying. It was not a popular decision. You had a tough fight.
We expected a tough fight. He came in shape at 222. I expected a tough fight.
Well, did you get very badly hurt in the first two knockdowns?
The man can punch hard. Anybody hit, you're knocked down.
All right, were you willing to give this guy a rematch? That was an even fight.
I'll give him a rematch anytime. Anytime you want a rematch, I'll fight him. I'm going for the championship.
What are you telling me for? What
all right,
I'm
we
going
are
for the title.
All right, Ronaldo, good luck. We're not going to leave for
that
your own safety. Things are